We've been building what I like to think of as DevTools as a service. For every deployment, you get this toolbar that shows up that gives you a bunch of different tools that you can use to help make your site faster, more accessible, and work with your team. And in this video, I want to share some of the recent improvements we've made, do a demo of a bunch of the different features of the Vercel toolbar, and tell you how you can add it to your site. So let's dig in. All right, so let's talk through some of these new tools. And as I reference them in this blog post, we can go check out demos for each one. Vercel's front end cloud, it's all about giving you and your team the tools to make a great user experience. You can focus on making your product great and iterate together with your team members. And collaboration here hasn't really always been easy. Sometimes you're sending screenshots through Slack or you're simulating experiences with lab tools. It can require separate infrastructure to spin up and manage all of your different pipelines, all of your different environments. This can cost a lot of time, a lot of developer time, especially for larger organizations, having to spin up a dev and a testing and a QA and all these different environments to really make sure your changes are correct before they land in production. Vercel integrates deployments directly into your workflow. So regardless of the source control tool of choice, GitHub, Azure, or your own CI system, Vercel has integrations to make this very easy. So every Git push, every change you make, you can get a live URL that comes with this toolbar and this set of dev tools. This helps your team iterate faster and work across different branches and across members of your team. It's really funny because we use the toolbar so much, I have this command to show it or hide it, that whenever we have images of the toolbar in the blog post, I'm like, wait, are these real comments? I need to go... I need to go in here and address. Okay, back on track. Beyond automating your CI and CD, the Vercel toolbar offers a suite of tools to make collaboration easier. So we're going to talk through the accessibility tool, Open Graph tool, INP, and then how you can use this in production like I have here. So let's start with the accessibility tool or accessibility audits. We want to make it as easy as possible for you to get feedback on how to build accessible web experiences. Now, we know that there's no set of automated tools that can make an accessible website. You have to have these tools, but you also need to do plenty of manual checks and develop and train and teach your team on what makes a good accessible website. So this doesn't solve everything, but it's another tool in your toolbox. It helps check against the web content accessibility guidelines, level A and double A rules. And we can measure here whether it's critical, serious, moderate, minor, and so on and so forth. So to give you an example, I was running the accessibility tool on our docs page, and there's a couple things that had slipped in here. So this first one was that buttons must have discernible text, and you notice it was pretty much all the things on this left sidebar here. So I hover over them, I get a little bit more information about what's going on. And if you click on them, you can log it out to the console. So wanted to fix this, and we actually just put up a PR that when I reran our tool in here, I'm going to show you what this looks like. If I go into our menu, I can click on accessibility audit and I can rerun this if I want, sure. And now you notice that we've solved that one. That one is gone. We have solved one of the pieces of our accessibility checklist. So you can just run this audit basically on any single page and try to get these down to zero. So handy tool to have. Open Graph previews. So you want to understand what your OG cards look like when you share them out on social platforms, whether that's X, formerly known as Twitter, Slack, Facebook, LinkedIn, Google search, Discord, so on and so forth. And you can really easily do that from here. So I was on our observability page, for example, this marketing page, and I can click into the Open Graph tool. I can see all of the metadata. I Open Graph metadata here, which is pretty nice. I can view the image and see how it renders in different environments here. And this is all just through Open Graph, just like that. So you can Command K into that. Next up, I'm just flying through these. The INP tool, or the interaction timing tool. You can optimize your website's responsiveness and user experience by measuring and improving INP. INP observes the latency of all click, tap, and keyboard interactions on the page, and it reports back their durations. INP is kind of hard to figure out, in my opinion. It's like kind of hard to detect and solve. So this has been really, really helpful for us improving the INP of our own website across our docs pages, our dashboard pages. We actually have another blog post that might be out by the time you watch this, maybe, going more in depth on IMP. We also have a blog post and a video that I posted a while ago about Core Web Vitals if you want to learn more. But it's a pretty slick UI. So let's say I go back here and I go down to this interaction timing. I click on here. You can see the different elements in here. And if I navigate around, I go to different things. I go to all. We can see all these different elements here. You can click in and learn more about them. Maybe I want to go into here. Luckily, everything on this page seems to be pretty good. 89 milliseconds IMP. So pretty happy with that. But if there was something that was in the 200 millisecond or the 500 millisecond, I can go in here and understand how I want to iterate and make those a little bit better. Using the toolbar in production. So this toolbar that we've been showing, it shows up on every single preview deployment here. But if you want to use this in production, like we're doing for our own docs, so that if I'm on this page, I can press the C button here and I can comment in. That's another thing we can talk through. But I can comment, I can add in some markdown styles, I can add emojis, I can upload images, I can tag people on my team, all this stuff I can do from here. I like to use it in production so that when I'm reading through the docs, I can tag in my team and I can say, hey, you know, we have a typo here. Hey, this thing could be a little bit more clear. This code snippet could use updating. Just a nice feature to have. Well, the toolbar in production is now easy because we have a zero config Chrome extension, which makes it really easy to turn on. You can also use it through an NPM package if you prefer. And if you want to do kind of a staff toolbar type thing. So that's nice. I just mentioned comments a little bit, but it's nice that you can quickly turn those into tickets with your favorite system. Mine's linear, or you can use Jira, GitHub, or Slack. You can view content from your headless CMS, your headless application. You can view layout shift, which I have an example of this here. I was loading the Vercel dashboard and we're really picky about layout shift. So we try to find and fix as many as we can. And I saw that this one popped up, but I can replay the shift here. It's subtle, right? There was just a little shift here. We're going to need to fix that one. So I'm going to have to make a PR to get that patched in. And then if you improve your layout shift, you improve your CLS, cumulative layout shift, you can go into the Speed Insights Vercel product, which monitors your Core Web Vitals, and see these trends over time. So you can actually see when you made a deployment, how that affected your vitals. Let's also talk about this content thing. So what if I'm using content from a headless application? Well, I have this post about Vercel functions I'm going to release at some point here. It's in a draft state right now. When I go down to the toolbar, I can see this draft mode button that allows me to view this unpublished content from a headless CMS. And actually, if I go back here, I can make sure I'm in draft mode on this page. This truth about INP. So we'll see if this is out by the time you watch this video, but this goes really in depth about INP, how it works. It's great. Really, really helpful post that can pair well with the toolbar change that we just released. And last but not least on here, this is the end of the blog post, but there's one more thing, one last thing I want to talk about, which is feature flags. Last but not least. So imagine you've got this great e-commerce store and you want to toggle a feature flag and you want to see what it's going to look like when you're running a promotion. Well, sure, I could go out to my feature flag provider of choice, whether that's a LaunchDarkly or similar, but Vercel now has the ability to integrate with your feature flag provider of choice directly from this toolbar. So I click on feature flags. I can see, okay, we have this summer sale. Show summer holiday sale banner, 20% off. So I'm gonna override this in the toolbar just for my session here in the browser. We're gonna say it's true. We're going to apply it, reload the page. And now I get to test and validate and make sure that this looks as expected. I can see summer sale, shop now, awesome. So it's really handy that I can override these things directly from here. I can search for any of my flags. I can filter my flags. And this integrates with whichever feature flag tool I want, or I can define my flags now through my code as well in frameworks like Next.js or Svelte. Stay tuned for another video on flags coming soon if you want to learn more about that. But I can override it, get back to where I'm at. So that's the quick story of the Vercel toolbar. There's a lot more that we could go into for each one of the different dev tools in this experience that works in your preview environments by default, or if you want to optionally install it in your production environments or on your local host. If you want to see more content about the toolbar, let me know and we'll make some more videos. Peace.